Teams has an irritating feature. When a meeting is finished, it lands up in chat. But actually, it's a very empowering feature. Let's understand why. The practical problem is, in chat, you're chatting with people or groups of people. But now, these Teams meetings are coming in the chat and cluttering the space. You can't find the people whom you talk to regularly. No problem, let's solve that. Go to the people whom you talk to regularly, click on the three dots and choose pin. Now, your chat list is divided into pinned ones and non-pinned ones. So just keep the pinned part open and the recent you can collapse. Problem solved. But that doesn't solve the problem. Why meeting became chat? So let's take a step back. You want to do audio call, video call, screen sharing. There are hundreds of apps available. What is common across all these apps? Oh, all of them have a start button. Yes. When the meeting is finished, you click the end meeting button. Done. The job of that particular software is done. I agree. But is your job done? Absolutely not, because meeting is not just happening in isolation. After the meeting, you'll have to do some kind of follow-up. Maybe you have to send files, collaterals, minutes of meeting, action item updates, clarifications, queries, all kinds of things. Now, none of these apps are going to help you for that. It's your problem. And it's not really a problem because you have already solved it. How have you solved it? Oh, you know the solution. Go to calendar because that's the only place where you can find the meeting. Right-click on it and say reply all. And then keep sending stuff about that meeting as emails. And then reply all to reply all to reply all. You know the story. For 30 years, we have been managing meetings like this. It's absolutely inefficient, but we just got used to that inefficiency. There was no choice earlier, but now there is not only a choice, there's a better way of handling it. The idea is stop sending mails to each other for post-meeting collaboration because Teams understands meetings and Teams understands chat. So what does a team do? Teams picks up the meeting, finds out who are the people involved in it, automatically creates a chat and gives it to you. Now, what are you supposed to do? Rather than getting irritated with it, start using it. Now, first thing you have to do is stop using email for post-meeting collaboration. Find that chat and continue the collaboration there. Now, what do you see in that chat? Of course, the recording, transcript, attendance report, all that is going to come automatically. But wait, before the meeting also, some collaterals may have been sent. During the meeting, some files were attached. All of them are available in the Files tab. Is there some shared note people have taken? Sure, that is also available. Poll was done, results are available. Nowadays, we have Q&A also, separate Q&A other than chat. That is also available. In fact, the best part and most surprising part is if you had used whiteboard during the meeting, that whiteboard is still available. Not as a bitmap, as an active whiteboard. You can continue whiteboarding even after the meeting is over. Isn't that brilliant? Now, it is possible that you need some other person who was not a part of the meeting to also participate in this activity. No problem. You can add that person and continue. Again, we saved lots of reply to alls. Every action you are doing here is saving lots and lots of email activity, which is great. Less effort and more impact. Having said that, it is possible that someone will still send a mail reply to all related to the meeting. Okay, no problem. What do you do? Open that mail and there is a very powerful button called Share to Teams. And now you choose the chat and stuff that mail there. So now it's still a part of post-meeting collaboration chat. Yes, you can include attachment as well. So first thing, the fact that meetings become chat is a good thing. Stop hating it, start liking it. Second, stop sending mails to each other. Convince others about the benefits of this. In fact, I would say every time when the meeting is about to get over, you explain this to people, let people get used to it. Better still, share this video with them so you save time and everyone is on the same page. And the best way to popularize this across the organization is to create a best practice. And that best practice has to be mailed to everyone, not by you, but by the boss or bosses, because boss's mail is always read. Isn't this useful? Let me know in the comments. And before you go, watch this Teams best practices video. It has 15 best practices which are simple, practical, and immediately usable. The rest of it you already know. Subscribe, like, bell icon, and there is a thanks button as well. So that's it for now. Happy efficiency.